That, except that the rock star Frank Zappa wrote the music. We report on the flip side of Zappa's art. Today's news headlines, Mrs. Symphony Orchestra are giving a concert at their home in the Barbican Centre. Nothing much new in that. But what is new is that the programme of orchestral music they'll be playing is music written by the celebrated American rock star Frank Zappa, a man once banned, if you remember, from the Royal Albert Hall because his lyrics were thought to be too obscene. Robin Denslow has been looking at the least known and the least commercial side of Zappa's art.
In the 10 months since it opened, London's concrete maze of an arts palace, the Barbican, has had its share of controversy. Tomorrow night, there could be some more. There's the first chance ever to hear purely orchestral works composed by one of the more misunderstood, colourful figures to have first emerged from the West Coast rock scene in the 60s.
These steps are pretty boring.
A man who has found it easy to combine outrage with musical excellence, and now serious orchestral composition with the unexpected.
And they have orange things here. Hello, my name is Frank Zappa, and I'm going to stand here and I'm going to talk to you for just a moment. Now just look right into my eyes. I'm here in a building that was approved by a committee. That means that it's not exactly uniform in its design. There are many things about this building which are quite nice. And there are other things about this building which are really ugly. The VIP room has things on the ceiling that look like belly buttons. Really.
Frank Zappa has been quietly writing pieces for a full orchestra alongside his rock work for years. For their first ever performance, he's using the London Symphony Orchestra and so many musicians that they might not fit on the Barbican stage.
It's going to be difficult. It's going to be maybe even painful for some of them.
And it's a very rhythmic pieces of work you're doing. There's lots of percussion and space-filling people like that.
Well, according to the diagram, the way it was originally laid out, the timpani would be there, percussion four is there, one is there, three is there, two is there, five is there, the percussion soloist is there, and the drum set is right there, okay? Now that occupies 30% of the stage with just that much equipment.
And then there's what, horn section,
and then there's
sections,
all the strings and the winds and the horns.
Winds, the whole lot.
Plus a grand piano and a celeste, which would go right there, and a harp, which is supposed to go there. Plus a conductor who has to stand right here and be seen by everybody and not fall off the stage. And I don't know how they're going to get it on here.
The conductor described it as the hardest thing he's ever had to do.
Probably will be.
What's particularly hard about it?
The hard thing about, same with many things in modern life, is to get large numbers of people to do the same thing together correctly on time.
So it's very tricky rhythm patterns.
There's complicated rhythm patterns, and there's things that are a little bit difficult to keep in tune because the chords are unfamiliar.
Zappa lives in the Los Angeles Rockstar Belt in the hills around Laurel Canyon. But he rarely goes out and spends most of his time in his own recording studio working. At home, he writes music of almost every sort, from this forthcoming song satirizing the LA cocaine craze to his recent hit Valley Girls, an attack on the rich and dumb young ladies of the LA suburbs that's made them a nationwide cult. For the public at large, his image is still that of the zany rock star. And for Zappa, it doesn't seem to matter that his simpler rock songs are far better known than the serious compositions.
I think that it's just as serious to write a song like Valley Girl as it is to write a ballet called Mo and Herb's Vacation. To me, there are equally serious problems in music.
Really? I mean, one must take you, what, a matter of days, and the other a matter of
Months and months.
Well, in the case of Valley Girl, it took me a matter of moments, but in the case of some of the orchestra pieces, they'll take like 6 months to write, but that doesn't mean there's any less seriousness involved in the construction of each piece, because they're for different mediums, they're for different audiences, and they deal with different kinds of musical problems.
This project must have cost a small fortune, getting this many people assembled.
Cost a large fortune.
How is it financed?
By me. And by you, who bought the records and bought the concert tickets and liked the Hot Rats album and all that stuff. I saved up money for years in order to make this happen. And I'm converting it back into sound waves for the people who are interested in that sort of thing. It'll be available on a record as soon as we mix it, and we'll put it out right away.
How much has it cost?
Well, I don't know what the total bill will come to by the time I'm finished with everything here in England, but I've spent $500,000 so far just on the paperwork. Just on
the getting the scores ready.
Copying the scores and parts and things like that, because it's been going on for at least 5 years.
The past 3 days, Zappa has been rehearsing his expensive hobby at Hammersmith Odeon, on the stage where he's often performed himself with a rock band. The LSO are rehearsing compositions that Zappa has written from 1975 on, but which he is only hearing now for the first time. The conductor, Kent Nagono, mostly works in San Francisco and was chosen by Zappa. As the LSO grapple with the highly complicated, unusual rhythm structures, Nagono agrees he's not given them an easy time. He regards the compositions as very important.
I guess I could best describe the music as being along the vein of the American composer Charles Ives, or perhaps the contemporary French composer Boulez or Messiaen. Now, or perhaps another more contemporary American composer, Elliot Carter. Now, on the surface, all four of these composers seem very, very different. But the reason why I make the comparison is each one of these composers, including Frank, has explored some element of an expansion of concepts of rhythm. You can look at any of these scores mathematically, but you can also look at it as just a form of thought to get a new form of romanticism across, and I think that's how I'm approaching these scores. In some ways, this music, I think, the fact that we're documenting it on recording, could be one of the most historical events of this particular century.
At the rehearsals, Zappa sat out in the stalls, but made sure that Nagono and the orchestra were always aware of exactly what he wanted.
If we can just bring the rest of these, the things that are making noise in here, down, all this metal stuff in here.
Do you want him to have another partner with him? I can assign another player. You know, first stand instead of one solo for now.
Why don't we split it up with all 1A's doing that? How about that?
Okay.
Excuse me. So could you take a look, please, everyone? 159. Ready? Amp.
Couldn't ask for anything better than what they're doing.
So Tuesday should be all right.
Tuesday should be better than all right. Even at 80%, this stuff is going to be fantastic.
Doesn't undersell himself, does he? Frank Zappa, the reporter, Robin Denslow. A late news story.